It's easy enough to set the colour of your RGB LED light bulb or strip to a specific colour using a colour picker in the Home Assistant app or the bulb manufacturer's app, but in reality most people only use a few set favourites, so wouldn't it be easier if we could just use a physical button to cycle through those presets? Well, in this video I'll show you exactly how to do that. I'm going to be using an Energizer RGB LED bulb in this demonstration, which is a Wi-Fi connected, Toya compatible device. If you're in the UK, you can pick these up for a fiver from B&M. I'm going to control the bulb with an IKEA smart button, which responds to a short or a long click of the button. This is a Zigbee button, so you do need a Zigbee controller in Home Assistant, like a Sky Connect or a Combi Stick, but you could just as easily use another brand of Wi-Fi or Bluetooth connected smart switch, or even a virtual helper button in Home Assistant if you wanted. I'm using this button because it's simple and I have a spare one to use for this demo. Now the first thing we need to do is figure out which colours we want our bulb to show. The easiest way to do this is to visit the W3C website and look through the extended colour keywords list. I'll put a link to this site in the description, but basically write down a list of colour names that you want to cycle through each time you press the button. So for example, you could choose aqua, blue, crimson, deep pink, green, whatever you want. Just make a note of them and the order that you want them in. Obviously, the longer you make that list, the more annoying it might be to cycle around to the colour you want, so just keep that in mind. Next, we need to create a drop-down helper in Home Assistant to store this list of colours. Okay, we start by going down to Settings, Devices and Services, and Helpers up here at the top. We'll click on Create Helper down in the bottom right, and we want to choose the type of drop-down. I'm going to give it a name, I'm going to call it Colour List 1, and we're going to start adding some options, and this is where you would add in your colours. So I'm going to add aqua, orange, magenta, and lime, and red, and then finally I'm going to stick blue in. We click on create and that has created it. There you can see it's at the top of the list and I can select from that list if I needed to. The final part of this requires an automation which will trigger when you press the button and turn on your LED, setting the colour to the currently selected value in the drop-down helper. Then it'll move the drop-down value onto the next colour in the list, cycling it around to the start if necessary. Okay, so navigate down to Settings, Automations and Scenes, and click on the blue Create Automation button and Create New Automation. Now for the trigger, in my case I'm going to create a state-based trigger and it's going to be my button action, and I want the button action to go on. Now I need to save this now and I'm going to call it Cycle Bulb Colors and save. Now to add my actions, I'm actually going to switch to YAML mode and paste in the ones I created earlier. As you can see, this one just turns on the light but with a color from the input select, so from the drop-down helper that we created before. Just make sure that this input select matches the actual one you created and it's listed here as well. And then also your light bulb, that must be the entity ID of your light bulb. In this case, mine's called light.testRGBBulb. So just save that and it's ready to go. So to show this in action, I've had to remove my green screen because otherwise it becomes a nightmare to edit. The colours of the bulb just make it impossible to key out the background. Anyway, I've made this special bulb holder here and it's plugged into the mains, as you can see. But when I press the IKEA button, it will turn on. Oh, and it's gone blue. If I click again, it should cycle around. That's a light blue, and that's an orangey yellow, and we go to pink, and then green. So you can see it does work, and it responds pretty quick, and that's red. And I've actually got another automation, when I hold this down, it turns it off. So that's a very simple automation really, there's not much to it. I will put the configuration up on my website and there'll be a link to that in the description, so please check that out. Please also give this video a like if you found it useful and don't forget to subscribe to my channel to see more from me. Thank you for watching, goodbye.